119 Carboxy. Today, I'd like to talk about mainly melanogenesis and cell signaling and transcription and modulation by natural product, and if I have time, inflammation and immuno-oncology. This is a mammalian skin. Mammalian skin has a lot of cells, mainly stratum corneum and stratum spinosum. And this one, these are containing keratinocyte. Here is a dead keratinocyte and live keratinocyte. And melanocyte is just on the basement membrane and produce melanin and transfer to keratinocyte to protect UV light. This is a summary of melanin production. Melanin is produced by tyrosine amino acid, and tyrosine, TYR, catalyzes tyrosine to DOPA or dopaquinone. And dopaquinone is further oxidized to dopaquinone. And tyrosine again catalyzed to other type of compound, and TRP1 and 2, tyrosine related protein 1 and 2, also oxidize dopaquinone and finally produce new melanin. New melanin is a black melanin. In contrast, dopaquinone conjugate with glutathione or cysteine. This pathway produce pheomelanin. Pheomelanin is a red or yellow melanin. This is a mouse color. Wild type mouse show brown hair. And we usually use black mice for genetic and pharmaceutical approach. This is a mutant color. And if tyrosine is deficient, this genotype makes albino. And TRP1 deficiency makes a cream, bright color. So melanin production very important for mammalian hair color. And this is a scheme for how to produce melanin. First, UV make damage in keratinocyte. Keratinocyte produce alpha MSH, melanocyte stimulating hormone. This hormone bind to the receptor on the membrane of melanocyte, MC1R. This activation produce cyclic AMP and activate protein kinase A. Protein kinase A activate phosphorylate and activate transcription factor CREB, cyclic AMP responsive element bind protein. CREB upregulate MITF transcription factor, gene expression of MITF. MITF is a specific transcription factor in melanocyte. And then finally, MITF upregulate tyrosine gene expression. Tyrosine translated on the ER and moved to melanosome. This one is a melanosome. And in melanosome, tyrosine convert to L-DOPA and L-DOPA convert to dopaquinone and produce new melanin combination with TRP1 and 2 or pheomelanin. And melanosome, after maturation, move to keratinocyte directly, and melanocyte move to the perinuclear region of keratinocyte and protect UV damage. This is a bird, a color of bird. I don't know how to pronounce Agapornis Roshikori is, we call Kozakura Inko. I have two types, this green type and blue type. And this bird is a green type is a wild type, and blue is a mutant. And this bird can produce red melanin and blue melanin and yellow melanin. In contrast, blue bird can produce only blue melanin. And probably this bird called Lucino can produce only red or yellow melanin. So melanin is very important for hair color formation of mammalian or birds. Blue melanin also familiar in human. European people have blue melanin in iris. Blue melanin is a very simple structure and the content also low. In contrast, Asian people have a black melanin in iris. Black melanin has a large conjugate of dopa quinone. In contrast, fair melanin, red or yellow, also make a conjugation. But this one probably due to hemoglobin, red blood cell, not fair melanin color. Hair color condition is not only the combination of melanin. Melanin content also determines the color of bird and mammalian. This bird, called American yellow, can produce red and blue and yellow melanin, but melanin synthesis is low, so light color makes light color. And bird also have albino. This one is a tyrosinase deficiency, but the potential is this bird can produce red and blue and yellow melanin. This one is OCA2 mutant with this bird can produce yellow melanin with hypomelanogenesis, produce very light color. And eye is red. This one due to hemoglobin, not due to red melanin. So important is the type of melanin and melanin synthesis rate is determined the bird and mammalian color. This is a mouse. Wild type mice show brown hair, and black mice is a mutant. And this one is AA or CC is a genotype. C is a tyrosinase. So black and brown mice has a wild type of tyrosinase, and A is agouti, determines the rate of melanin synthesis. And this mice has a large A dominant, and this one is recessive A. And albino is a deficient of tyrosinase. In addition to such kind of color, we have yellow mice, agouti yellow. These mice have to be maintain small A and A wild. When black mice mate with white mice, baby is all brown mice because large A come from here, small A here, and large C from here to small C here. So F1 generation make a wild type phenotype. In contrast, black mice mate with agouti yellow make two type, brown, black or yellow. Small A is here and here and here, and large AY is come to here. So this combination only produce black and yellow mice. Why we have to maintain such kind of complicated mating? This is a gene of mice agouti locus. Melanin synthesis rate determined by agouti. Wild type has this type of gene formation. Agouti and Larry. Larry is very important for survival. Black mice, small a, has a transposon in the promoter of agouti gene. This transposon disrupts expression of agouti. In contrast, AY has a big deletion in this region. So agouti protein level is very high, but Larry gene is disrupted. So AY mice cannot survive. So we have to maintain black and yellow mice this way. Dog has also have agouti locus, and wild type dog looks like this. AY, wild type, and agouti tan is looks like black region is predominant, and also black dog we have. And agouti yellow also, dog has this type of hair and gene, but in case of dog, this is not diesel. So brown hair dog can maintain brown AY and AY mating. So how agouti regulate hair color? This is a melanocyte. MSH bind to MC1R, activate cyclic MP Krebs signaling, upregulate MITF transcription. MITF induce tyrosinase and TRP1 produce black melanin. However, agouti protein block or function of MC1R and downregulate MITF gene transcription. So downregulate tyrosinase activity makes low content of melanin and produce conjugation of cysteine. And this type of enzyme produce yellow melanin. This is a mechanism of how overexpression agouti makes yellow hair. And this mouse also another phenotype, obese phenotype, because MSH also regulate appetite in the brain. So overexpression of agouti protein cannot block appetite. So overeating makes obese. From now, I would like to talk about my PhD course thesis, salt-induced kinase and melanogenesis. Almost 30 years ago, I was a PhD student. I isolated one kinase named salt-induced kinase, SIK. SIK belongs to chalcogen kinase family and MVK family, makes a family with SIK1, SIK2, SIK3. This is a human kinase tree. And SIK3 may be evolutionary origin. This was found in C. elegans and insect and fish and mammals. SIK2 also found in insect and vertebrate. And SIK1 is only in vertebrate. Expression pattern, this one is mRNA, but not so important. What is a SIK? SIK is induced by cyclic MP signaling and may be regulated Krebs mediated gene expression. So first we examined we prepared overexpression cell line in sterogenic tissues. And SCC and STAR is a sterogenic enzyme. And when we activate cyclic AMP signaling by ACTH, thick overexpressing cell cannot express SCC or STAR expression. So thick maybe inhibit Krebs function. To understand molecular mechanism, we try to the substrate using peptide overexpress as a GST fusion peptide and add the P30 ATP and determine the consensus sequence. And SYK can phosphorylate leucine and arginine, serine, and serine is a target of SYK. So next, we try to identify substrate using database. And database showed one family of transcription co-activator, TORC. TORC is a transducer of regulated Krebs activity. Now, this one is called as CRTC, Krebs regulated transcription co-activator. SYK may be phosphorylated here, and CRTC can bind to Krebs directly. So maybe SYK may modulate CRTC activity. So first we checked CRTC cell intracellular localization using GFP technique. When overexpress CRTC as a GST fusion protein, GFP signal distributes not only nucleus but also cytoplasm. However, GFP is co-expressed SYK1. Nucleus signal is disappeared. So how to CRTC activate Krebs? This is a summary. And CRTC is usually localized in cytoplasm as a phosphorylated form. The cyclic AMP and calcium signaling activate dephosphorylation of CRTC. Then CRTC move to the nucleus and bind to Krebs and activate target transcription. However, SYK is induced by cyclic AMP and phosphorylate CRTC. As a result, CRTC is captured in cytoplasm, not in the nucleus. And transcription is inhibited. So target gene is more than 2,000. And one family is the sterogenic genes. The other is melanogenesis genes. This is a summary of sterogenic cells. SCTs bind to MC2R and activate cyclic AMP signaling and activate pKa, pK phosphorylated Krebs. At the same time, CRTC is activated. SYK is activated by induced by pKa, but at the same time, pKa suppresses SYK. This also the same case in melanocyte. Maybe MSH bind MC1R and activate cyclic AMP and activate pKa and Krebs. SYK may be inhibited melanogenesis. To show this model in vivo. Moreover, ACTH and MSH share same peptide. ACTH processed from POMC peptide And MSH is produced by ACTH. So ACTH and MSH signal is very closed. To show SYK is important for melanogenesis, we used agouti yellow mice. Agouti yellow mice has a SYK2 wild type. In contrast, we prepared black mice with SYK2 knockout. First, we mate, and F1 generation produced black and yellow mice, but the SYK2 is both a hetero genotype. And mate these mice each other, produce black type and yellow type. But the SYK2 is a three type. One is a knockdown, and hetero, and wild type. As shown here, knockout of SYK2 produce darker hair of yellow mice. So SYK2 may be important for the regulation of melanogenesis. This is a model. MSH activates cyclic MP and activates CREB, but SYK2 inhibits CRTC. But without SYK2, this inhibition is not observed, so MRTF is overexpressed, and the tyrosinase of also overexpressed, make darker hair. So SYK2 may be important for CREB regulation, and we can show by mice model. Next, we try to modulate melanogenesis by small compound using by screening of SYK2 inhibitor and identify several flavonoids. Using an in vitro assay, we found fusetin can highly inhibit SYK2, and diosmetin and tamarisetin also inhibited SYK2. However, using CREB assay system, for example, CRT, CREB activity, CRE activity is induced by cyclic MP, force coding addition, is suppressed by SYK2 overexpression. However, in the presence of fusetin, this suppression was not observed. In contrast, luteolin cannot suppress SYK2-mediated suppression of CRTC efficiently. In contrast, this type of diosmetin and tamarisetin efficiently inhibit SYK2 activity. So we have controversial result. So we checked the melanogenesis using B16F10 melanom cell. Diosmetin and tamarisetin produce enhanced melanogenesis. However, fusetin cannot produce excess melanin. So next, we checked using agouti yellow mice. At first, I would like to explain the result of B16 melanoma cell. Fusetin cannot induce melanogenesis, but diosmetin can induce. However, in case of mice, both fusetin and diosmetin can produce can stimulate melanogenesis in agouti yellow mice. This enhanced melanogenesis is reversible. Without flavonoid, these mice hair color is changed to more bright. So we have some contradiction between cell system and in vivo. So we check facial content of flavonoid. This was a feces of mice intake fisetin. This is authentic standard. Fisetin and methyl fisetin looks like this. And in feces, we have two types of fisetin. One is original fisetin, and one is monomethyl fisetin. However, this was naturally found 3' methoxyflavonoid. Methoxyfisetin is naturally found, but 4' methoxyfisetin is not natural. So we have to synthesize this kind of fisetin. But we can easily to methylate this position, and we can purify 4' methoxyfisetin and check cell system. And this methoxyfisetin enhanced melanogenesis in B60 melanoma cell. So fisetin cannot, but in vivo, fisetin can induce melanin, and methoxyfisetin can also induce melanogenesis, which is accompanied with high level of tyrosine expression. So, 4' flavonoid may inhibit SIK2 in vivo and enhance the melanogenesis. So using this flavonoid, we confirm anti-hair graying activity using X-ray irradiation. X-ray produce hair graying, but the fisetin intake protect hair graying. So we prepared hair conditioner containing such kind of flavonoid. And now $5 million, this kind of hair conditioner make a sale more than $5 million per year. And this also supported by other groups using human skin. Some special SIK inhibitor, they can succeed to reproduce our result. SIK inhibitor enhance MITF production and produce high melanin, enhance the melanogenesis. So this technique is not only by fisetin. Acasetin or kempferide probably contained in diaper also inhibit SIK2 activity and produce high melanin content. So in future, maybe this kind of source may be helpful to make a hair conditioner. So now I would like to back to kaolinic acid. During the screening of fisetin, we also found some very curious compound, kaolinic acid. We found this kaolinic acid in Pteris dispar crunze. And this one is very, very rare in Japan, but mainly found as a glycosylated form. We have two types of this Pteris. One is Pteris dispar crunze, found in China and Japan and Korea. Looks like this. In contrast, Pteris semipinnata, found East Asia, very similar, but leaf is a little bit different. And we can purchase this pteris from Yahoo, a little bit expensive. So first, we identify melanin inhibitory activity of this probable ethanol extract. And in fraction 6, we found a very, very big peak. But using recycling PCR, recycling HPLC, this one is automatically recycles the peak and separate some ingredient. And finally, we identify fraction A and B. Fraction A has glycosylated kaolinic acid. Sixth position is not, sixth position is different. And melanin assay showed only fraction B has anti-melanogenic activity. So we purchase another kind of kaolinic acid and try to examine structure activity relationship study and found the importance of 11 hydroxylation and 15 oxo and 16N is essential. Lack of one moiety, no melanogenic suppression activity was found. So we conclude this one is a responsible ingredient in Pteris dispar. In contrast, 90 position important for cellular toxicity. If 19 has a carboxy, no cellular toxicity was found. However, methyl or ethanol makes a cellular toxicity. So 19 position is important for safety. So to examine this kaolinic acid is efficient in vivo. First, we examined human 3D skin model. This model is require high amount of compound. So we used 1 millimolar of 11-hydroxycaolinic acid. 1 millimolar of this compound completely inhibit melanogenesis. And melanin is found in basement membrane, but no melanin was found here. Using zebrafish, we also found anti-melanogenic activity of 11-hydroxycaolinic acid. Melanin content is decreased in zebrafish. So next, we try to identify molecular mechanism of kaolinic acid-mediated melanin suppression of melanogenesis. First, we check enzyme activity of tyrosinase. However, tyrosinase activity is not suppressed by this kaolinic acid. Next, we check MITF level or MITF activity, but this also not changed. The sensitive site is a tyrosine mRNA and protein level and tyrosine promoter activity. So maybe target is near here. This is the data. This one is a MITF mRNA level. 11-hydroxycaolinic acid weekly a little bit suppressed MITF mRNA level in basal condition. However, when cyclic AMP signaling is activated, this kaolinic acid cannot suppress MITF mRNA level and protein level. In contrast, tyrosinase MRI level is strongly suppressed by kaolinic acid. This is also the case of undercyclic MP activated condition. Tyrosine protein level also suppressed by the addition of kaolinic acid. So the target may be after MITF expression and before tyrosinase mRNA expression. So we checked MITF activity using chimeric promoter. This promoter has a three motif of MITF binding site. And this reporter activated by overexpression by MITF or cyclic MP. However, kaolinic acid failed to cannot suppress this reporter activity. This means kaolinic acid cannot directly suppress MITF activity. However, using tyrosinase promoter, this is a promoter activity, and black is induced by cyclic MP. Kaolinic acid suppressed both basal and cyclic MP dependent tyrosine promoter activity, dose dependent manner. So we examine which part is important. Again, we focus on MITF binding site. Tyrosinase has two MITF binding sites. One is upstream, marked M, and one is downstream, marked E. So when M is disrupted, tyrosine promoter activity is strongly suppressed and not induced by false coiling cyclic MP, but also no difference was found even when kaolinic acid was addition. In contrast, position E is disrupted. Tyrosine activity also down-regulated, but in addition of kaolinic acid, this promoter activity is still suppressed. This was enhanced by cyclic MP. Kaolinic acid suppressed this mutated promoter. So we conclude M is essential site of kaolinic acid. Next, we prepared a number of deletion construct. So a little bit complicated. First, this M site is disrupted. This one is a fold suppression by kaolinic acid is weakened. However, if promoter region also disrupted and exchanged to another type of promoter, this construct completely lost kaolinic acid response. This means not only this MIT binding site, but also promoter region important for the response to kaolinic acid. This is a sequence of the MITF binding site. MITF bind this CATGTG sequence. Near this sequence, highly AT-rich region is conserved from mammalian to birds. So this one is a target of FOXO transcription factor. So we confirm this region important for the response to kaolinic acid using artificial promoter. This is the artificial promoter. First, delete 10 base region of this region. Lost, completely loss of action of 11 hydrochloric acid. And one region back with a FOX binding region. 11 hydroxy response is a little bit recovered. And three copy of back. 11 hydroxycholic acid response is highly enhanced. So we conclude MITF binding region with FOXO1 binding region is essential for the response to chorionic acid. Next, we confirm the involvement of FOXO1 in the regulation of chorionic acid dependent suppression of tyrosine promoter. Overexpression of FOXO1 upregulates tyrosine promoter activity. And in the presence of chorionic acid, this upregulation is completely canceled. So probably MITF may be upregulated tyrosine gene expression co-regulated with FOXO1 and 11 hydrochloric acid suppress FOXO1 activity and downregulate tyrosine gene expression. This is one mechanism, not only this mechanism, but at least FOXO1 may be important for chorionic acid mediated suppression of tyrosine gene expression. And this is summary. Chorionic acid suppressed this sequence, but this one is a one of mechanism. Other is important for promoter region. So chorionic acid can inhibit both action and suppress tyrosine gene expression. We don't know how to suppress tyrosine promoter, but in this year, we can find a new mechanism. Next, I would like to show our activity for commercial use of this chorionic acid. To use commercially, we have to check some of toxicity in human. This is a result of patch test using with 15 Japanese. But results show no irritative activity or inherited activity in 50 Japanese people. Using this examination, we also found some benefic effect. This was inflammatory due to soap washing. But addition of extract, we can clear some kind of inflammation. In addition, in mouse model of atopy, also cleared by extract. But this one is extract of Pteris grunze. This one containing very low amount of chorionic acid. So it's not good for commercial use. So we try to identify other source of this chorionic acid and found Adenostrum labenia grunze. This plant is containing high amount of chorionic acid. So we think this one is a very a good source of this chorionic acid and for medication. This is a HPS analysis of water extract of A. labenia and Pteris dispergrunze. And This arrow shows the 11 hydroxycholinic acid. Then we sequentially extracted by chloroform. Two-step purification makes very high quality of kaolinic acid, very simple method. However, from Ptes dispar-Kluunze, very few amount of kaolinic acid can extract by water and chloroform extraction. From this result, we conclude a Ravenia is very helpful plant to extract this kaolinic acid. This is a distribution of Adenostoma Ravenia. This plant distributes all over the world, Japan and East Asia. And China and Taiwan use this plant for anti-inflammatory herbal medicine for pneumonia and inflammation. In I don't know East Asia, but some document is show root for stomach ache or diarrhea. However, no use of record for human use was found in Japan and Western country. So we found some, we tried to find some literature. This is a literature of A. Ravenia in Taiwanese Ministry of Health. And in Taiwan, this A. Ravenia called Shimota Kiku, but I don't know read Chinese, but in some document, some kaolinic acid is contained in this plant. And this is a English version of this web page. And this also shows this plant is used for pneumonia. So maybe in Taiwan, this plant is now used for anti-inflammatory medication. So first we compared efficacy of water extract between Adenostoma Ravenia and Ptes dispar-Kluunze. And this one is a dilution. And found anti-inflammatory activity, almost the same efficacy. Probably this one, Adenostoma Ravenia, this kaolinic acid is the main ingredient. In contrast, glycosylated kaolinic acid is the main ingredient. And this is a we have shown before, A. Ravenia is a kaolinic acid efficiently extracted water. And chloroform extraction make very, very pure. But Ptes dispar-Kluunze not containing free kaolinic acid. So to study the function of kaolinic acid, this plant is very, very helpful. So we purchased this plant from Taiwan, and we've collect several lots, sample F, G, and H. H is a supplement. Taiwanese pharmaceutical company produced supplement of this plant for anti-inflammatory medication. And this one is a water extraction. So Taiwanese A. Ravenia containing high content of kaolinic acid. supplement a little bit low. And Japanese A. Lavenia also contain high level. But a little bit pattern is different. The Taiwanese A. Lavenia shows a small peak and later large peak, small and large. In contrast, Japanese A. Lavenia has a large peak, then small peak. So we examine the content or structure of kaolinic acid is the same or not. Using LC-MAS, we identified three types of kaolinic acid in Japanese A. Lavenia. One is 11 hydroxy kaolinic acid. The other is 9 and 11 hydroxy kaolinic acid. And 11 and 15 hydroxylated also found in Japanese A. Lavenia. This is the data of HPLC analysis. We confirmed NMR. So proton can identify three types of kaolinic acid. So why Japanese and Taiwanese kaolinic acid is peak of kaolinic acid different? We wonder, maybe A. Lavenia in Japan and Taiwan may be different. So we try to examine by genetic level using mitochondrial DNA sequencing. This was 2 years ago. At that time, we have only information of Chinese A. Lavenia voucher. So using this sequence information, we determined a DNA sequence. Moreover, we have some derivative of A. Lavenia, Madurans. So determination of mitochondrial sequence found Chinese A. Lavenia is same as Japanese A. Madurans, but Taiwanese and Japanese A. Lavenia has two mutations. One is missense mutation, the other is nonsense mutation. But the sequence pattern is completely same. So Japanese A. Lavenia and Taiwanese A. Lavenia is genetically equal, but a little bit different from Chinese or Japanese other species. However, content is completely different. Japanese A. Lavenia and Japanese A. Madurans contain high level of 11 hydroxy kaolinic acid and low level of 9-11 dihydroxy type. But 11 and 15 hydroxy also equal contain Japanese A. Lavenia. But Taiwanese 9 and 11 hydroxy kaolinic acid is a major, and 11 is not only a very few level. So we could not identify reason why the content of pattern is different between Japan and Taiwanese. These are genetically same, but the content is different. So we have to examine the biological activity of this Japanese type and Taiwanese using these three types of kaolinic acid. First, examine effect on melanogenesis. 11 alpha and 9 and 11 hydroxy kaolinic acid efficiently suppress melanogenesis, but 11 and 15 hydroxy kaolinic acid cannot suppress melanogenesis. This is also supported by the expression level of tyrosinase protein. tyrosine protein level is suppressed by 11 and 9 and 11 alpha hydroxy group, but not 11 and 15 hydroxy group kaolinic acid. Next, we try to identify effect of effect on anti-inflammatory activity measuring NO and the expression level of iNOS. iNOS produce NO and NO induce number of inflammatory signal. So NO measuring is a one good indicator for anti-inflammatory activity. This is a result. This one is a NO production from macrophage. 11 hydroxycaolinic acid and 9 and 11 hydroxycaolinic acid efficiently suppressed NO production. But 11 and 15 hydroxycaolinic acid failed to suppress NO production. And this one is a time course of iNOS protein induced by LPS, lipopolysaccharide. iNOS protein efficiently induced after 8 hours of LPS stimulation. And 11 hydrocarbonic acid efficiently suppressed this enhancement. And this also observed by 9 and 11 hydroxycaolinic acid, but not 11 and 15 hydroxycaolinic acid. So this result also the same with anti-melanogenic activity. This was a measuring of iNOS mRNA. 11 and 9 and 11 hydroxycaolinic acids efficiently suppress LPS-induced iNOS mRNA level. And as cytokine level also suppressed IL-6 and TNF-alpha expression, also suppressed these two kaolinic acid, but not by 11 and 15 hydroxycaolinic acid. So this was also similar result with anti-melanogenic activity. And collaborate with Irumanida sensei. Irumanida sensei showed this kaolinic acid has an antioxidative activity using a yeast system. To explain Japanese researcher, this was prepared in Japanese, sorry. Irumanida sensei shows addition of 11 hydroxycaolinic acid protect yeast from oxidative stresses. So high content of hydrogen peroxide completely kill yeast, but addition of kaolinic acid protect yeast from damage caused by hydrogen peroxide. This protection accompanied with overexpression of PAP1 transcription factor. PAP1 transcription factor is a homologue of mammalian NRF2. NRF2 also important for antioxidative activity in mammalian cell. This is a model of NRF2 mediated regulation of antioxidative stresses. Under non-stress condition, NRF2 transcription factor captured by KEAP1 protein. And this complex facilitates NRF2 to move to proteasomal digestion. So under non-stress condition, no gene expression was induced. However, once oxidative stress attack KEAP1 protein, KEAP1 release NRF2 and NRS2 move to nucleus and upregulate antioxidative stress genes such as hemoxygenase 1. This scheme already shown by this type of kaolinic acid, pterizoic acid B. So we examine whether our kaolinic acid also activate NRS2 by disrupting function of KEAP1. KEAP1 is attacked by this kaolinic acid. KEAP1 is degraded. And P6T is a good indicator for this degradation. So we examined this system using our kaolinic acid. This is protein level. NRF2 is induced by 11-hydroxycaolinic acid, very, very early period. And hemoxygenase 1 also induced by later phase. Next, we examined a structure activity relationship study. 11-hydroxycaolinic acid and 9 and 11-hydroxycaolinic acid upregulate NRF2 protein level and upregulate hemoxygenase 1 gene expression. This one is a protein. And 11-hydroxy and 15-hydroxy do nothing. This is mRNA level. NRF2 mRNA level not induced. Protein is induced. So this induction is maybe protein level. In contrast, hemoxygenase mRNA expression level is induced by 11-hydroxycaolinic acid or 9 and 11-hydroxycaolinic acid. And this regulation is a gene transcription level. To confirm this, we prepared promoter assay. ARE is a NR2 binding site. This is a artificial reporter monitor NR2 activity. This reporter is activated by 11 and 9 and 11 hydroxycaolinic acid. So these kaolinic acid may activate NR2 activity. This one is a reporter using hemoxygenase promoter. Hemoxygenase promoter is very, very large, so we prepared a basic promoter with ARE site. This artificial promoter upregulated by 11 and 9 and 11 hydroxycaolinic acid, but not 11 and 15 hydroxycaolinic acid. When delete this region, no response was found. So hemoxygenase 1 induction, maybe ARE is responsible. And finally, we checked a KEAP1 expression level. Difference a little bit small, but 10 micromolar of 11 and 9 and 11 hydroxycaolinic acid downregulate KEAP1 protein level and upregulate P62 protein level. So KEAP1 downregulation is a trigger of NRF activity induced by kaolinic acid. And this one is tyrosinase promoter, and this one iNeS promoter. Overexpression of NRF2 suppress tyrosinase promoter and iNeS promoter. So NRF2 is important not only for upregulation of hemoxygenase promoter, but also important for suppression of tyrosinase promoter and iNeS promoter. So in addition of FOXO1, we can identify NRF2 as a regulator of tyrosinase promoter regulated by kaolinic acid.
以上の結果より、 台湾および日本。
Sorry. this is a summary. 11 hydrochloric acid has a multiple function. One is anti-melanogenic activity. This one also observed in mouse larva. The other is an anti-inflammatory activity coupled with anti-wrinkle formation. This one is collagen and elastin. This one important for anti-wrinkle function. And MMP9 and ELA2 disrupt this formation, but the chorionic acid suppress the expression of MMP9 and ELA2. So important for skin formation. In addition, chorionic acid has an antioxidative activity. And recently, we found 11-hydroxychorionic acid disrupt ACE2 protein. This was famous for coronavirus receptor. So, but a little bit, we need high amount. So in the future, we would like to use the source of this chorionic acid, ELA-VENIA, for the treatment of coronavirus patient. So we would like to show other function in vivo. Another type of chorionic acid already found to help for pneumonia. This was reported in 2016. So, but a little bit different from our chorionic acid. But Taiwanese group already found ELA-VENIA extract cure pneumonia. This is a mouse model of pneumonia induced by LPS treatment. And dexamethasone efficiently cure the inflammation in lung. And ELA-VENIA extract also cure the inflammatory activity in lung. So ELA-VENIA important source for pneumonia. For medication, we try to modulate or to get chorionic acid with high activity. We try to modulation 19 position using NO production. We found hydrophobic modification efficiently suppress NO production, but no suppression of anti-melanogenic activity was found this derivative. And when this derivative back to hydrophilic derivative, anti-melanogenic activity is recovered and no inhibition of NO production was observed. So we tried to another type of derivative. One is this one, 1901 and 1902. And this is a cellular toxicity. 1902 is highly toxic, so not good. NO production was not observed in both 1901 and 02. And however, we don't know why INOS protein level is suppressed by 01. In contrast, Anti-melangic activity, we can restore, we found a restored anti-melangic activity in 01 and 02. So modification of 19 group change rate of NO production, anti-NO production and anti-melangic activity. Next, I would like to show immune checkpoint activity. Immune checkpoint is, this one is a tumor, and this one is a natural killer T cell. Natural killer T cell protect our body from tumor by directly attack with tumor formation. And tumor has a express PD-L1 and T cell express PD-1. This signal suppress T cell activity. This one also act as a defense system from T cell attacking in tumor cell. So disrupting this system called immune check, this one is a immune checkpoint. So we are now developing a immune checkpoint inhibitor. At this moment, immune checkpoint inhibitor, efficacy of immune checkpoint inhibitor is only 20-30%. Adverse effect is autoimmune disease is found in 30%. And cost is very, very high because to disrupt this system, we have to use antibody. So we try to this system using 11-hydroxycholinic acid. Probably efficacy is 30%. Autoimmune disease, we don't know because 11-hydroxycholinic acid is anti-inflammatory activity and the cost may be low. So we prepared some of derivative at 90 position. Methyl, ethyl, butyl, hexyl, octyl. And this one is ionos promoter activity. Kaolinic acid efficiently suppress ionos promoter. But some derivative, hydrophobic derivative, efficiently suppress ionos promoter. This one is a 3 micromolar, but octyl derivative can suppress only 0.3 micromolar. In contrast, PD-L1 expression, immune checkpoint, pattern is different. Methyl group, methyl type is efficiently suppress PD-L1 expression. So we can separate anti-inflammatory activity and anti-immune checkpoint activity. So using such kind of derivative, we can make efficient anti-tumor drug without autoimmune disease. This is a preliminary data of anti-tumor activity of Enravenia extract. So this gray is the only water, and the blue is with Enravenia water extract. And the tumor is here. And this one is the rate of mouse found in tumor. So Enravenia extract treatment suppress tumor formation, but tumor volume is not different. So we have to modulate more active 11-hydroxycholinic acid and make more efficient suppression of tumor formation and tumor volume. In addition, some of discrepancy was found even in melanogenesis, This is another type of modification at 90 position. Number four is more simple, and number five is a little bit complicated. But anti-melanogenic activity was found only this type of derivative, not simple type. So we did check enzyme activity of tyrosinase and found number five efficiently inhibit tyrosinase enzymatic activity. Number four is not so high. So when we started this study of kaolinic acid, we found a suppression of tyrosinase gene expression. But this kaolinic acid may have potential of inhibited tyrosinase enzyme activity. So using some kind of structural activity relationship study, we found a real mechanism of biological activity of 11-hydroxy kaolinic acid. This is also the another biological activity I mentioned before. Metalloproteinase 9, MMP9 expression level is suppressed by A. Ravenia extract. This is also important for tumor migration. So inhibition of MMP9, good for produce anti-tumor drug. In addition, neutrophil elastase ELA2 also suppressed by 11-hydroxycaolinic acid. This is also important for skin care. Japanese cosmetic company sells very high sale of this cosmetic named Wrinkle Shot, anti-wrinkle cosmetics containing neutrophil elastase inhibitor, NEEL1. This also produced as a drug from Ono Pharmaceutical Company, Silvestat. This also inhibitor of neutrophil elastase. This also efficient for inflammatory bowel disease. So downregulation of neutrophil elastase also important for anti-inflammatory medication.
I'm sorry, so, Professor Hitsitakemori, for interrupting. The time is 2 minutes remain. 2 minutes remain.
Okay. This is a, sorry, this one also Japanese, and we compared to some anti-neutrophil elastase, and this one is A. Ravenia extract using blue light damage, keratinocyte damaged by blue light, and cell survival were counted. A neutrophil elastase inhibitor suppressed cell death, but A. Ravenia extract more efficiently suppressed cell death. So A. Ravenia extract may be good for more efficiently suppressed neutrophil elastase. So this is the final summary. This kind of kaolinic acid has multiple function, especially now good for skin. So in the future, we would like to prepare cosmetics and anti-inflammatory drug and anti-tumor medication. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you so much, Professor Hiroshi Takemori. It's such an interesting topic. Now I invite the student whom have question. If you have questions, you can ask Professor Hiroshi Takemori directly, please. You you can raise hand and unmuting yourself. Is there any question? No question? Or you can write down the question on the chat column. Or if you want to ask directly, please raise your hand. All right. Actually, I have a question to Professor Hiroshi Takemori. Because at your introduction, talks about melanin and melanogenesis, I heard about blue is the rare color of living creature. There is only small number who have a blue color. Why blue melanin or blue color is rarely found in living creature? Is there any explanation of that?
Probably in human, we have a very huge blue melanin. But another mammal or bird, can produce a lot of blue melanin. So it depends on species, I think. So I don't know the exact reason why blue melanin is very rare in human. Sorry.
Okay, it's okay. Thank you. Thank you for answer, Professor Hiroshi Takemori. Okay. Oh, turns out on the chat column, there is question from Algen Yasipa. She want to ask about the application of visetin as skin product. As Professor Hiroshi Takemori explained before, that visetin has potential to prevent hair graying by promoting melanogenesis. Can it use as treatment of hyperpigmentation in human skin? That's the question.
Hypopigmentation?
Yeah, hyperpigmentation in human skin.
Hyperpigmentation.
Mm-hmm.
Hyperpigmentation. Using this hair conditioner, I have no heard such kind of hyperpigmentation, but I had can helpful to protect hair grain. So this type of flavonoid helpful anti hair grain, but not induce hyper melanogenesis. May I correctly answer?
Mas or Mbak Elgiani, is it okay the answer? Oh, no comment. Oh, who's Hotima asked the question maybe? Mbak Sadil, can you hear?
Yes. Okay, can. Is there anyone raise?
Yeah, Ibu Husnul, Ibu Husnul raise hand.
Okay.
Thank you, moderator. I would like to ask, thank you, since Hiroshi Takemori Sensei, for your explanation. There are very complex and very interesting research. I would like to ask you about my research. I want to hear your opinion and maybe your suggestion, because now I try to develop a skincare for anti-aging and also for UV protection. I measure the antioxidant activity and also the wrinkle and collagen, MMP9 also. But I use combined two herbs and then to increase the efficacy, to increase the penetrate of the, because I use it as topical and I make it become nanoparticle. I mean, transversome and also nano emulsion, and I make it become one gel. Because in my opinion, in one herbs, maybe that will have some active compounds that will be synergistic effect. And also the important reason is the price to isolate one compound. What do you think about it? It will be better if I use crude extract and make it become nanomaterial to increasing the efficacy, rather than I use one molecule to increasing efficacy as well, but it has, maybe it will be highly cost. Thank you, Sensei.
No, thank you. So you mean nanoparticle?
Nanomaterial, yes.
Also helpful to enhance the activity of such kind of compound?
Yeah, because I compare one groups, I give it only a crude extract without make it become nanoparticle, and compared to the some dose that I make become transversome and also nanoemulsion, and the nanoparticle will be give a better result than only extract.
Okay, thank you. I would like to try in the future. Thank you.
So Takemori sensei, maybe she asks about your opinion about how to, if she will make it into nanoparticle, is it better or no? What do you think?
Maybe better, but I cannot imagine now how to prepare one. So. In the future, I would like to try, yeah.
Maybe the second question is, Husnu, maybe you have the second question. How if we mixture the compound, yeah?
Yeah, because as we know that we, especially in my campus, there are still the technology is very limited. So, and also we have a target that people know. Yeah, you know, in Indonesia, maybe if you make it single compounds with highly cost, it will be also we have to sell it in high cost as well. So that's why I try to use crude extract and combine more than one herbs. And also, as we know, the lecture from the speakers always isolate one molecule and define very clearly, very sophisticated to evaluate many activity and very sharp what we call maybe pharmacophore or site of action. But if we use crude extract, so we don't know which active compounds will active or which one will be have a good result. But maybe using in silico study, we will get the more information for the activity of some compounds. That why, because in Indonesia, maybe I'm from Brawijaya University Malang, So for very limited, yeah, we have HPLC, we also have LCM, SMS, but the frequency of a researcher is more than capacity of our instrument. So that's why we use crude extract. Thank you.
Yeah. So we also compared some of extract and isolated compound, but we have to understand the molecular mechanism. So at first, we study using a purified compound, but for commercial use, it's better to make some mixture or some formula. So we will develop some good source of Lavinia, and also some containing other kind of plants or extract, make more efficient herbal medicine. So at this moment, I can study only a purified carbonic acid.
Okay, thank you
so much, Professor Hiroshi Takemori, for the answer, and for Husnu for the question. Because time limitation, we end this session. Thank you so much, Professor Hiroshi Takemori, for the lecture and the answers. Hope the pandemic over as soon as possible and you can come here. Thank you so much, Professor Hiroshi Takemori.
Thank you, Takemori sensei. See you again.
Next, we will listen explanation about final project description and group performance from Dr. Wulan Triwahyuni. Listen carefully about a lot of important information and following me. Make notes and questions, if any, to Dr. Wulan Triwahyuni. Time is yours.
Thank you, Sadila. Okay, I will try to share my presentation. Can you see my slide, Sadila?
Yes, ma'am. It's already shown.